On today's video, thanks to the cool folks at Model Rectifier Corporation, MRC. They've been around for decades and decades. They sent over HobbyBoss's all new tool, 1/72nd scale, and I'm not going to read all that. Nope, not going to happen. What it is, it's a tiger tank on a train car on a train track diorama, all in one box, 1/72nd scale, multiple painting options, all the stuff you see on the box top is in the box, nothing left out. So let's take a look at all the parts so I can get to building mine. First up is a comprehensive decal sheet. These are mostly in white, so you can just see the silhouettes as I go by. They're mostly markings for the rail car. Few for the tank on the bottom, gives you a couple options there. And you can, of course, go ahead and paint your tank any way you want. They do have a nice full color guide if you want to do the full camo one. What I like in seeing in these pictures is that it looks like this is the steel wheel version of the tank. So we don't even have to paint road wheels separate. We got a bunch of nice little detail on there. It's got some ideas in the manual for solid color tanks and all that. Looking at the parts, we've got multiple repeated trees because it is a nice size kit in 1/72nd scale. You can see the size of my hand compared to that. Nice railroad bed with ballast just begging for weathering opportunities. We've got our rails right here, all crisply molded. HobbyBoss makes a beautiful model kit. It's got ends to the base that snap and glue on. We got joiners for the rail to rail, end to end. Nice, looks awesome, molded in a tan plastic, tannish yellow. So we get two of those trees. I won't show every double tree. I'll just let you know that there's two of them. We don't need to bring them right into camera. Let's get a bunch of the stuff on this side of the table out here. This also lets me fulfill for a long time. I haven't been able to work on a model railroad. I just don't have the space in my basement anymore. I have it filled with other stuff like plastic model stuff and RC stuff. So I haven't worked on a model railroad since I was a kid. And this allows me to get a little bit of railroad fix in. We've got the trucks for the train car. You can see the nice size on those. Different components for those. You get two trees of those. You get two trees of the wheels. Nice flanges on there. We get to do some metal weathering on that wear surface. We get to do some weathering on the train car, on the tank. This will be a fun one. This will be, they're all fun, but this will be exciting. The tracks are molded as one piece with the inner road wheels. Now we're going to be painting things up. We can easily detail that. We can work on the tracks. They got all their nice sag molded in and all that. So we'll be able to put those on either side of the tank. The back side will have detail. If you flip your tank over, you'll be able to see it. All the road wheels crossing. And because we don't need to get rubber on these wheels, that's why they're all molded as one piece. Because you can paint them up all together. We got our other half of our drive sprocket. Then we've got our road wheels going all the way back and our idler in the back. And then we've got some of the extra wheels that will be placed in to interlace them with these wheels as we go. We can paint them all either together or off the model and assemble them later, whatever you prefer to do. Here's the hull so you get an idea of 1/72nd scale, Tiger 1. Nice looking. We got nice large pins. You can actually see the suspension arms on the side. So it is lovely to see on there. Drive wheel or the idler in the back there, whatever it is, the drive gear, if that's what it is. I don't know all the perfect names for the Tiger 1 tank, and I'm completely okay with that, and you should be too. We have fun with them, and that's all that matters. On these trees here, we got the awesome upper hull. We got our tow cable attached, which would be painted on the hull anyways. You can always go ahead and weather it. We've got some entrenching tools and tanker tools. We've got paintbrushes that are small enough to detail all of that. Get in and wash inside the grills. We got our skirts on there. Molded beautifully. Check out the detail on that. Even though it's 1/72nd scale, look at that machine gun. Obviously, it's upside down in this, but look at that. Amazing. Tiny little, it's got a front sight on it. 1/72nd scale, check that out. Got the back of the tank, got the front with the little machine gun port and the driver's sight port. We've got loading ramps and stops for the tank to get it on. the rail car. It just can't drive up the back. It'll destroy it. So that's the support. This is the part that bridges from the support to the rail car. And this is the main ramp from the ground up to the top. Awesome traction, diamond plate texture. Definitely tell this is modern molding. This is the size of the rail car. It's all one piece, got the bumpers on the front and the back. Beautiful rivet details. The experts will want to count those, make sure they've got the right number all the way down. So if it doesn't, they can slag it online. It's actually missing one half of an actual rivet, and it's unacceptable. See, the bottom of the rail car's even got molding in it. Pretty amazing, amazing stuff. We got parts of the turret here, the mantlet, a one-piece barrel. Cut those little nibs off there. That's not flash from the barrel. Got nice little hatches and access points. Mantlet looks awesome. Can't wait to get this thing together and start getting paint on it. Here's the steel frame of the train car. Molded with relief on both sides. Outstanding. Sides of the turret. Extra track molded in place. It's 1/72nd scale. We've got tanker's tools, shovels, tow hooks. Look at a little part there. I don't even know what it is. Sides of our turret. Bustle on the turret. Looks like the gun will be able to be raised and lowered, but we'll find out. I probably will just glue it into place. And then we've got two of these trees with various small parts, accessories, straps, mounts, brake wheels on the train car itself. You will get two trees of those parts. Outstanding molding, even on the finest parts. So that looks like a lot of fun. I'm gonna get to building mine. We'll be right back. Being 1/72nd scale, there are a lot of details, but not a lot of parts. The entire kit is just over 140 some parts. I think 148 is listed on the box, and that's all. But you really get a very nice model. We'll look at some of the parts on the trees now that we know what they are. Of course, these are tow hook points. I'm going to leave those off and attach them with super glue later, because I know when I weather the tank, I'm going to break those off. This is the little tiny machine gun barrel for the very front of the tank. These are, of course, tanker tools and shovels. Those will be attached to the tank after we get those painted and everything. So we're going to leave those off on the side. These here are chocks for the track on the rail car. And these are large posts that sink into these square holes on the side of the rail car, where they can attach chains and railings and stuff along the side and straps to hold the tank in place. So we've got two trees of those that I will be detailing separately so I can work on them. We've got the awesome detail on this little machine gun and its mount that goes on top of the turret. Obviously, one, I'm going to be painting these black so I can detail them with a little bit of dry brushing, metallic dry brushing, and glue those on later. I certainly don't want to put them on now because there's no way that's going to survive the weathering. The outer road wheels and drive wheel, I want to get those painted so that I can get detail inside the tracks where I attach the other wheels, just the four inner and center guide wheels. I've got that attached in. I can get this all primed on both sides, then detail it all, weather it, then I can weather these parts when I paint them, and finally attach them for a much better 3D effect towards the end. And luckily, these aren't rubber treaded road wheels that I can tell. It looks like they have steel wheels on them. So that's according to the box art. I'm going right on the box art where the camo extends all the way to the very edge of the wheels on there. I don't see any rubber and all that stuff. So we're going to paint them up exactly that way and deal with them. So I've glued those together. There's an inner set of wheels and an outer set of wheels, and then we will glue that very final set of double wheels as well. These things had a gajillion road wheels interlaced to hold the track in position and support it all the way back. On the ramps for the tank itself, we've got the ramp that attaches to the rail car. Make sure you leave these moving so that you can adjust your angles when those push in, just friction fit into the back of the rail car. We've got our ramp, which is like so. I'll be detaching that to paint it. But we've got our ramp here with this key mark. That goes on the rails and straddles them. And then our ramp has that same key mark in there that will press it in solidly and hold it in place for your diorama. And then these two parts towards the end will just snap together like a snap tight, and we will locate that all on top so that our Tiger will weather that up so that our Tiger can actually get up onto the rails. The Tiger itself is a beautiful little kit. Here's our turret. I'm going to be painting them separately and detailing them separately. We have excellent details on the turret, on the mantlet, on the barrel molded in one piece, but it looks lovely. You can see underneath doesn't need much. We got our bustle rack on there. We've got hatches. If you have a 1/72 scale German tank commander, feel free to leave that hatch up and make it your own little diorama as well, guiding the guys driving it on. If you have 72nd scale characters, you could put them around on the rail car and on the bedding. We've got that lovely looking Tiger One. I've got the exhausts on, which are actually three separate pieces on this tank. You can see I draw the part numbers on the parts that look the same, so I know that I put them in the right place. We've got our fenders on the back. We've got all that beautiful molded in detail all the way around, where it will be easy to work, weather. We'll do a little hand painting on these tanker tools. They would have been painted right on the vehicle when it was painted up in the scheme that I'm going to be doing in. So we'll get those a little more detail. The rail car is a lovely piece of work. We'll detach the trucks. You can see how the trucks just press into those large pins there. The rail car looks lovely. I will warn you, these little rails down here are very, very fragile. They broke, putting them on the back, they broke right in half. There was no way I could salvage them. So how we solve that, this will be the end of the rail car that's exposed on the track. We'll put our ramp on this side. If I would have broken a different one, we could just turn it around. But I've got two that are in great shape. We've got our lines and our hoses. We've got our bumpers like they have on the European train cars. You don't see these on American train cars. You just see coupler to coupler. We've got our little couplers there. We've got our wheels on either side. Those actually glue into place. Beautiful design on that rail car. You can see where those rods will go in along the sides. You can see where the ramp will push in and join in solidly. The frame underneath, which we'll never see again. The trucks are really detailed for being 1/72 scale. They've even got scale brake shoes on both sides that you install. Along with these rods, they actually push in one piece and glue in. They look wonderful. Lots of detail. The suspension is completely different. That pushes into the trucks. So you have very nice looking trucks to go with your rail car. Or if you want to use the blown up, you know, if you want a Tiger that was on the rail car strapped down and it's blown off the side, you could leave a truck on the tracks and detail that. You'd have all kinds of fun. As you can see, I've only done two sections out of the four of track, because you saw that everything fit on that beautifully. The rail joiners are in place. The rails just push in from either end. I think once they have paint on them, that will be very hard to push them in without ruining the paint. So I pushed them in. We'll hand detail everything after I get the primer coat on it and some base color coats. I will go in with craft paints. We're going to detail the ties, detail the rails, use some metallics to highlight those rails. We're going to make it look awesome. We got our ends on there. The seams, you really can't even tell where they are. I mean, you can tell because of the join, but you go to the other side, there's rocks coming off that side. The ends are on beautifully. Once we get some weathering done in there, you're not going to tell. They go together lovely with the snaps there. You will then, if you do it with just two, you're going to have diorama parts left over. You've got two extra sections of rail. You've got rails. You could put them on the side like they're going to fix the rail. You could have two dioramas with two tracks like a siding. You could do whatever you want with all that stuff. You've got all the leftovers, but I can tell you that two pieces of rail will fit the entire diorama as it is out of the box without stretching at all. So I'm going to head to the paint booth. I'll see you over there.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, a nice extended building session because I have so much fun building these and doing some light weathering and making them a little dirty that I just enjoy showing it. Now we've got the rails all done. You can see we've got the metallic top of the rail where the train cars back then, when Germany was transporting things through Europe and all that, the train rails in those days were used all the time. So the tops of them stayed relatively rust-free. And you can notice that by walking over railroad tracks that you see nowadays. I did lay in a darker wash of that pavement color down the center. I figure all the oil, grease, and coal dust and everything being deposited in the center of the rails back in those days, even by if they were using some of the newest diesels, but mostly steam engines. Then I did some dry brushing on the ballast. So we've got it all accented and it looks really nice and it looks like a real piece of Eastern European rail. We've got the rail car ready to go. That will end up just placing over the top like so. I've got some dirt tracks on the wood top. I did it in a more of a red color. These flat cars were all different colors depending on where they scavenged them from, used them from, whatever. So give it your own mind. If you want to paint it like the box where it's all German gray, go ahead. I wanted some different colors and ideas and stuff with it. So we've got the metal ramp with its brace underneath and how it arches over the top. That's all a press fit connection. And you can see just pressed together, it fits quite well. We'll be attaching the rail car to the rails with a couple drops of super glue right on the wheels because I never want this to move or have a chance to fall off. So that's going to look pretty awesome. We're not going to get a chance to look underneath, so I didn't bother painting any of the stuff where I secured it for painting because, as you can see, it is completely invisible when you actually set the model on the base. And we actually don't get to see a lot of the rail, but you can kind of get a glimmer of it from the sides and whatnot. So I wanted to make that look nice. And I like railroad tracks, and it was a weathering experiment, and it turned out pretty well. The Tiger tank looks wonderful. It's a beautiful little model, even though it's 1/72nd scale. The 1/35th scale tanks, of course, will have much more detail, but I managed to get some dirt stains in it, some light chipping, did that weathering with the Tamiya accent colors. You can see how they bring everything out. Got it like it's a used tank. Got the tracks, the bare metal tracks on the turret rusted up. Got our black wash. Got the exhausts rusted. Got a little bit of dirt on it underneath. Didn't do too much underneath because these beautiful looking track systems will completely cover it. These are a steel track. So after I rusted and dirtied them up, I then dry brushed the top. The contact points will almost always be bare steel the minute it travels over anything. The very bottom didn't get painted, but I even got that a little decorated so that you can see it when it goes underneath. And then our wheel package, road wheels, drive wheels, idler, all looks awesome. And that is just going to be a press fit onto the tank. We maybe even can do one on camera. We'll just line those holes up on the back side. Press them in. And there we go. That's half our Tiger tank wheel track system installed. The other one will press on. Once it's on place on the train car, I will attach the little machine gun. I will attach all these little girders to hold the tank on and the tank chocks. They're not wheel chocks. And then I will do the decals. Now, normally I would apply the decals to the train car right away and then weather over them. But what I was seeing on some train cars when I ride past this rail yard behind a craft factory in my town, they actually are refreshing these all the time because these marks here tell them what the load is, tell them where it's going, and all these different designators. So I'm actually going to put them on now like they got refreshed, like this is a new load, and they're going to be hauling it, so they want to have all the information on that car. So I will be putting it on like they had just put those marks on with a white grease pen on the side and marked up the rail car. So that's all that's going to take. I'll apply all those little decals, get the tank's markers on it, because those wouldn't have been faded. It's a yellow tank. I didn't dirty it up or fade it that much, so I can apply the small number plates to it, and that's all it needs. When I get done, we'll have the final. There's a bunch of firsts for me in this video. This is my very first Tiger tank build. It's my very first building an entire rail car. Back in the day, I did build some Athearn rail cars, but they weren't as detailed as this right out of the box. And it's my first 1/72 scale build. As far as I can tell, I did a quick search of the channel. Maybe I forgot one, but all together. So we got the railroad track is one kit, the rail car and the loading ramp, another entire kit, and this awesome 1/72 scale Tiger One tank, which is, I think, one of the coolest tanks of World War II. All put together. We did it all in 2 days, a super easy build. I was pretty intimidated when I saw the box. The MRC was going to send it over. I was like, yeah, I definitely want that one. Could you please send it? They sent it over. I'm like, kind of waiting. And then finally, did it on the new kits video, put it together. I really enjoyed it. This was not difficult. The parts are small, so be careful. You know, you don't want to be breaking stuff like I did with those handles. But as you can see, those steps underneath here that I talk about breaking, you can't see them underneath the other side anyways, pretty much. So it's fine. But just be extra careful with yours because you'll probably want to make sure you can see them. You have more time to work on your model and stuff like that. But this thing is really, really cool. Now, I've got the rail car just tack glued with super glue to the tracks. But the tank itself isn't. So you can position it down here as if it's driving up those ramps. Make sure to take these poles off if you're going to have it just driving up. You could put 72nd scale figures. If you're building for use, you're not building a review out of the box, go ahead, expand the base out here so you can add other armored vehicles. You can add some of those other pieces of like rail laying on the side, like they had to repair the rails. You can do all kinds of stuff with a nice diorama. Add some grass and some other debris on the sides. But for me, this is how I want to set it up, right like that. I like it like they just pulled it up. I got the wheel chocks. I got the other bars here and stuff. So I want it like they just driven it up, put against the wheel chocks that are on the track, and now they're going to start securing it. You could use some wire for straps or whatever you want to hold it on the rail car. It's a giant Tiger tank, so usually the wheel chocks and the weight of it are enough. But, you know, do whatever you want. Make up your mind and have fun. And that's the most important thing. This kit was easy to assemble. Everything went together beautifully. You saw how easy even the tracks went on. They just pushed in. All the other parts just needed a little bit of model glue. Extreme detail on the little machine gun, on the tools, the tanker tools, the cables. The molding is first rate, which is what I expect from a modern kit. The rail car is beautiful. The decals laid down without a fight whatsoever. And the track was beautiful. You saw the highly detailed track. Highly recommend this kit. It's available right now. I will link to it on MRC's website. Otherwise, if you have a local hobby shop, take in Hobby Boss, this kit there. Watch the video. The product number will be in the video and on MRC's website, the actual product number, and tell them you want this kit and build it up and have a great time. So always remember with your hobby, have fun, smile, remember it's your pastime and it's supposed to be enjoyable, and build what you want to see. Do you want a desert colored tank on a red oxide rail car on a track that looks like Eastern European? Then you go ahead and you build that and you decide. You want it to build it camo like the box. You want to build it Panzer Grau with the gray. You build what you want to build and have a great time. And what I'll do is I'll see all of you at the next review. Thank you.